Rachel Garceau with the On Your Side forecast.
Welcome back on your Monday morning. Welcome to a new week and a brand new month. So let's talk about the month of July, shall we? Some of our typical statistics for the month. So the average temperature for the 1st of July, how we start the month, we're usually our normal is right around 87 degrees. And by the end of the month, we're to our hottest average daytime high for Boise of 93 degrees. So you can see this is a very, very warm month. Daylight wise, we're starting off today with 15 hours and 22 minutes of daylight. But by the end of the month, we'll have lost almost an hour of that precious daylight, 14 hours and 36 minutes of daylight expected on the 31st of July. And this is one of our two driest months of the year. August is drier than this, and typically we only see in Boise for the entire month about a third of an inch of rain. That is it. And of course, we're kicking things off on a dry note. It doesn't look like we're going to add any precipitation for the first week or so of the month. We do have some storms that are coming in, some moisture that will come in, but most of that activity will really favor the higher elevations if it happens at all. And you can see here on our weather trend, we see a dip in temperatures just in time for the 4th, giving us a very comfortable Independence Day, and then the more typical July-like heat will set back in. And today we will likely add another 90 degree day to the City of Trees roster. We've only had one so far this month. Back in the middle of July, we saw one day at 91 degrees. We'll likely be about 92 for Boise this afternoon. So we're caught in between high pressure off to our southeast and then that low pressure to the northwest, and that area of low pressure will be on the move today and will send a cool front our direction that will send temperatures dropping across the entire region and could trigger a couple of stray thunderstorms. So this is McCall's extended forecast. I don't want anyone to panic and think that this is going to be a washout of an Independence Day because you see a chance of a shower or a storm. It's only a 20% chance. This is not a big storm maker necessarily, but all the ingredients will be there on Wednesday and Thursday for a stray shower or a storm. And I mean stray. They'll be scattered and spotty in nature if they pop up at all, and they should be short-lived if those storms do happen. So in McCall, it'll be comfortable, low 70s for the 4th of July afternoon, but there is again that slight chance of a shower or a storm. So it's worth a mention for you if you are headed to the higher elevations to celebrate the holiday. But again, I would not cancel any plans. Just be prepared for that spot shower or storm for the middle of the week. Now, none of that today across the region, just hot and a little breezy by this afternoon as that cold front gets closer. But when it's 94 degrees in Vail, Weser, and Ontario, you will welcome that wind, right? 91 on tap for Kuna today, 92 in Boise, and 93 with mostly sunny skies in Mountain Home. As you head to the hills, 87 for Idaho City and 90 in Garden Valley. So you have to keep on climbing if you want to beat the heat today. Highs around 80 in McCall, Donnelly, and Cascade. A little more comfy as you head up in elevation. 79 for Stanley and 80 degrees in Sun Valley. Fairfield, you'll enjoy the low 80s this afternoon. In the Magic Valley, it'll be hot as well, flirting with 90 in Twin Falls with that high of 89 degrees. Quick check of that extended forecast shows the sunshine sticking around through the week down to 81 by Wednesday. 82 in Boise for your Independence Day. Then very hot again this weekend.